Time relief is coming to hundreds of fishermen who can't work because of the oil leak. WDSU News anchor Randy Russo picks up our team coverage live in Venice. Randy, tell us how many people showed up for this training today and what are they learning?
Well, you know, it was amazing, Camille. There's about 300, maybe even 400 people inside of Boothville Venice School Auditorium earlier today. They all were just concentrating their efforts on really trying to clean up what they're calling their lifeblood, their main source of income, and what they've done since many of them were 10 or 12 years old. Now, some of the things that they discussed were some of the hazard training that they may have to go through if they do get picked by BP or to the Coast Guard to help out with this oil cleanup. You know, they talked about some ventilation hazards, maybe what would happen if you breathed in some of this crude oil. They also talked about touching the crude oil and the harm that it could have to your skin. So they went through a brief training session today. BP, British Petroleum, also announced their Vessels of Opportunity program, saying, you know, if you have a 20-foot boat and we need a 20-foot boat, then, you know, let us know and maybe you're the person that we'll contact to help put out boom. And many of these fishermen or fisherwomen, they'll act as boat operators while they'll have fully trained response members really working with the oil and picking up the oil out of the Gulf and some of the tributaries around the Gulf Coast. Camille.
Randy, a lot of folks have been talking about one thing, and that is about getting paid. Will the fishermen get compensated for their work?
Oh, they will be paid. As the amount right now, that's still a number that's kind of getting worked out. It depends on, number one, how long your boat will be used in the water, also the kind of crew that you're going to need. So a lot of variables are being put in place, and they hope to have a decision made on that by tomorrow morning.
Any word on when they'll be called to work, Randy?
Oh, they could get called out as soon as tomorrow morning, Camille. You know, it depends on the resources that each one of these fishermen or fishermen have and the resources that either the Coast Guard or BP needs at the given time. And again, if you have an 8-foot boat and that's what they need, if you have an airboat and that's what they need, or if you've got a 20-foot fishing boat and that's what they need, that's basically going to depend on who gets called first. But they do say everyone be patient because it could be hundreds of fishermen that they end up calling out, up to maybe even 1,000 by the time this whole thing is over, Camille.